Reading in my Bible one day, and I read in there about the Antichrist. You see, he is a lot like the false prophet in similar ways. And I was reading in Daniel 11:37. Neither shall he regard the God of his fathers, nor the desire of women, nor regard any God, for he shall magnify himself above all. But in his estate shall he honor the God of forces. And the God whom his father knew not shall he honor with gold and silver and with precious stones and pleasant things. Thus shall he go in the most strongholds with the strange God whom he shall acknowledge and increase with glory, and he shall cause them to rule over many and shall divide the land for gain. Now the Antichrist, this is saying, will not desire any woman, not a man, not even an animal, but he will only desire demons. Now, this was revealed to me by the Holy Spirit because I looked it up in Hebrew, and it says, where it says in our Bibles, God, it should be gods in both places. And we know that the house of Windsor follow after all gods. No, not just one god, but all gods known around the world, and this is known by all men. But this was not enough for him that he would desire a woman, for he desires demons to lay with them. And now I've been told by several people that they are now too lying with demons. So this is becoming commonplace upon the face of the earth. For we are truly living in the end times. So we read here in verse 38 through 39, and we see in 39, it says, he do in most strongholds with strange gods. And when we look this up, it says, by meaning, demons in high places. He will be looking to these demons for his strength, as we do our Lord. And with the strange god, who is Satan, this will cause him to rise in power as the kings in the past did to our Lord, our God, Yahweh. The book and TV show Dr. Doodiddle was mocking the Garden of Eden. For in the Garden of Eden, Adam could talk to all the animals. And this is how the snake that Satan entered could fool Eve. For he was beautiful to look at, and he talked to her. Just like I'm talking to you and you can talk to me. And the Antichrist is in the image, as I've already showed you, in the image of Jesus Christ. So he will be able to do fake miracles and talk to the animals. Talk to the animals just like Adam did. And fool people around the world. Now, look at this scripture. For the Holy Spirit keeps telling me his real name is within the scripture. Let's read it together. Revelation 13:18. Here is wisdom. Let him that has understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of man, and his number is 666. Now the only name I see here is the beast. And when I look up the word beast, it says it is a brutal, bestial man, savage and fierce. So I tell you that his name is the beast. And his number is 666. I hope you have full understanding. If anything I've talked about in my videos, any of them ever posted, please ask me questions. I'm not untouchable. I'm just a plain old person just like you. I'm nobody. Just a person. Now, I've seen in the spirit, in a vision, the Antichrist at Coronation. It is a ceremony, and he's drinking something like honey out of a cup. And when he turns around after drinking out of this cup, he's at the Bin Bin Stone. at the coronation seat, and his face is not the one that we know. Now, I had this picture that I no longer have, and I cannot refind it. I've tried. I've searched for 2 days. And in this picture, I'll try my best to describe it. This person has on a blackish purplish robe, which means royalty. And this robe, you can see that their body is full of little tiny demons. And I would call these demons a legion. And this person has taken off their mask and they're faceless. This very much describes what I saw in this vision. A faceless person full of a legion of demons standing on the Ben stone on the coronation seat. Now, I do know that on the day of the coronation for all the kings, queens, etc., that they take an oath to Satan. And on this day, they are filled with many demons. But as this Antichrist goes along, he will be filled with more and more demons. As we read in Daniel 11, plus he has no soul. So whatever he does to mankind, he will have no remorse whatsoever for what he does. The Holy Spirit showed me today that people's eyes are blinded by the truth as to who is the Antichrist. And as they are told the truth, their eyes will glass over like milk poured across their eyes. For they already drank the lies sent out by the false prophet. And today this was exposed to me on November the 26th, 2012. The Antichrist will be a practitioner of black magic, witchcraft. As you see, this is in Daniel 8:23-25, as it reads, in the latter days of their kingdom, when the transgressor have reached their fullness, a king shall rise, having fierce features, who understands sinister schemes. His power shall be mighty, but not by his own power. He will destroy fearfully and shall prosper and thrive. He shall destroy the mighty and also the holy people. Through his cunning, he shall cause deceit to prosper under his rule. And he shall exalt himself in his heart. And he shall destroy many in their prosperity. He shall even rise against the prince of princes, but he shall be broken without hand. You see, there is no need to make anything up, for Yahweh saw it all long before our time. Here he is called a king, but this tells us he is dishonest, he's treacherous, he's a cheat. Oh, surprise, he lies too, and he betrays. He looks mad in his countenance, in his ways. So this is what I was being shown in my vision at the coronation seat. He will become mad like an animal, is what that is saying. So now let's look at Daniel 9:26-27. And after 63 weeks shall a Messiah be cut off, but not for himself, for the people of the prince that shall come shall destroy the city and the sanctuary, and the end thereof shall be with a flood, and the end of the war, desolation, are determined. And he shall confirm the covenant with many of 1 week, and in the midst of the week he shall cause the sacrifice and the obligation to cease. And for the overspreading of the abominations, he shall make it desolate, and even until the consummation, and that determined shall be poured out upon the... Here he is, the prince, when he, the Antichrist, comes to destroy the temple. And now let's look in Revelation 17 and 8. The beast thou sawest was and is not, and shall ascend out of the bottomless pit, and go into perdition. And they that dwell on the earth shall wonder, whose name was not written in the book of life from the foundation of the world, when they beheld the beast that was and is not and yet is. Here he is called the beast. Thessalonians 2 and 3. Let no man be deceived, you by no means, for the day shall not come except there be a falling away at first, that the man of sin be revealed, and the man of perdition. Here he's called the man of sin and the son of perdition. 2 Thessalonians 2 and 9. Even him whose coming is after the working of Satan, with all power and signs and lying wonders. Here he has all power. He is also the lying wonders. Here in James 3 and 15, such wisdom descendeth not from above, but is earthly, sensual, devilish. And where envy and strife is, there is confusion and every evil work. So this wisdom is not from God, our Father, but it is from Satan that people will think that he has. Let's look at Revelation 13 and 8. All inhabitants of the earth will worship this beast, and all whose names have not been written in the book of life belonging to the Lamb that was slain from the creation of the world. Here again, he's called the beast. Revelation 13 and 14. And deceiveth them that dwell on the earth by the means of those whose miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beasts, saying to them that dwell on the earth, that they shall make an image to the beast which hath wounded by the sword and did live. Frogs are unclean again, spirits that I've seen myself Revelation in vision, 16 and 13. And then I saw the three evil spirits now let's that look back looked like a frog that came out of the mouth of the dragon, of the and out of the mouth of the beast, and out of the mouth of the false prophet.
At the north gate, in so the temple here again of Diana in the Bible in Ezekiel 8. How interesting.
Now the dragon was originally an S-S-Y-R-O, Babylonian fertility god, who was part fish and part man. Like the one that I've shown you that was revealed coming up out of the earth in that scripture. He was worshipped by the earthly Amorites, the Sumerians, and the Anadathians. Sorry, I'm not very good at pronouncing names. If you've been following me, you know that by now. As well as many others. His name was Zeus at Gaza in the Bible. And the Philippines called this particular entity their god. Strangely, he also was called Merman. Let us take a look at this picture. It is tell us that the prince is part angel, part bloodline of Christ, and part demon. Many look up to Diana as an angel when she was alive, even more so now that she is dead, for they set up shrines in her behalf and worship her right along with the other gods. This picture is showing a false prophet and the beast, who is the Antichrist once he comes into full power. I know who the false prophet is. I've been shown his face, but I do not know his name. Here another one in a different view. One part demon, the blood of Christ, and the demon seed speaking to an angel. Just like the beaker I shown you in part one, do not move on until you see all of this. The beaker where there was three birds. Remember? Also, they represented the same things. This picture also shows us the body of a human
the blood of Christ, and the face of a beast. He took the DNA, the image of Jesus Christ. See the image? He's holding it in his hand. Now let me show you some more names of the Antichrist. He is called the Wicked One in Isaiah 11:4. That Wicked in 2 Thessalonians 2:8 through 12. The Prince that shall come in Daniel 9:26. The Little Horn, Daniel 7:8. He's called Gog, the Chief Prince, in Ezekiel 38:2-3. He's called the Extortioner in Isaiah 16:4. An extortioner is someone that's obtaining money or property by threat to a victim's property or loved ones. He's intimidating you or taking false claims of a right. Not a very nice person, right? He's called the King of Babylon in Isaiah 14:4. He's called the Assyrian in Isaiah 10:20-27. And I was like, the Assyrian? Lord, that's not someone from England. So I spent most of my night last night praying. I slept a little. I was like, Lord, I know your word is true. And all your promises are yes and amen. But Lord, I don't understand that scripture. I just don't get it. And I need you to show me how he is the Assyrian. I looked it up. Still didn't understand it. So I prayed and I prayed and I was like, Lord, I just don't understand. So I woke up at 3:30 this morning and he led me to some searches on the internet and he gave me the answer. Because his word is true. Let every man be a liar. And I was able to complete this part of this video because he is true. And I give praise to him forever and ever. The Messiah that the Jews are looking for, the Israelites, the true Israelites. Now, this is some of the requirements. The Jews have many requirements for the one they are considering to be their Messiah. But remember, they're going to be fooled by the Antichrist and think that he is their Messiah. So this is some of their requirements I found. He will be the descendant of King David. You'll find that in Isaiah 11:1. So you might want, if you want to look these up, you might want to get you a notepad. He will bring peace among all nations. You'll find that in Isaiah 2:4, Malachi 4:3. He will bring perfect harmony and abundance in nature. Isaiah 11:6-9. But some interpret this as an allegory or peace and prosperity. All Jews return from exile to Israel. This is in Isaiah 11:11-12, Jeremiah 23:8-30-3, Hosea 3:4-5. And there will be universal acceptance of the Jewish God and the Jewish religion and the people of all cultures, nations. Find that in Isaiah 2:3, 11:10. 66:23, and you'll find it also in Malachi 4:2-3, and Zechariah 14:9. There'll be no sin or evil, and all of Israel will obey the commandments. You'll find that in Zephaniah 3:13, and Ezekiel 37:24, because they're going to think they're all in peace, and you know their God has returned. But it's not God, is the Antichrist. And we will build the temple in Jerusalem and gather the stray ones to Israel together for the temple. This is Ezekiel 37:26-27. He will be the messenger of peace. This is Isaiah 52:7. Ezekiel 37:24-28 pretty much sums up many of the requirements it proclaims. I was looking for how could he be, stayed up, like I said, all night. How could he be the Assyrian? How could this be? And I asked the Lord to show me. Because this is a fallen empire. It's one of the lost tribes. And so I found this statement. It's just a little small statement on the internet. After praying all night long, where I found this. These rabbis have been discussing this matter. And it says they've been moving toward the belief that England, Ireland, and Scotland, and Wales may be, in fact, contain their so-called lost tribe. Lost after the Assyrian captivity of 700 BC, when the 10 tribes, having been scattered, are believed never to return to Israel. The Assyrian ancestry called their land Arthur. The Ingo-Germic form of the Semitic word Asher. This may be the hidden reason that Prince Charles and Prince William have the name. Because after the fall of the Assyrian Empire, the Roman historian Plime, mentioned a tribe of the Asturians among the Sicilian people north of the Black Sea. Another researcher, Leon, notes that the ancient Barivian account of the people of Barivia came into Central Europe from the region of Armenia of the Black Sea. Considering this information, it is not surprising to find that the Arab writers describing the Germans as Assyrians, the Israelites. This is the link between between Germany and the Assyrians can be found. And are neither far-fetched or imagined. A fourth Reich from Tomorrow's World magazine. Here is the lineage of Prince Charles. Sorry I couldn't get it to be any larger so you could read it, but it's got lies in it anyway. It doesn't matter. It tells that they are related to King David and Jesus Christ, and that's a lie. But it doesn't matter, like I said, because it doesn't have any weight. Because as the Antichrist rises in his time to enter into the gates of Israel, and Jerusalem begins to once again cry out for their king and the divinic the Messiah, the Antichrist will say, I have the bloodline and I can prove it. Let me tell you, it's not what you think. So here comes the time for the Antichrist to walk, like I said, into the gates of Jerusalem, and it will do him, and they will ask him to prove it. And this paper is a lie. It won't do him any good. But remember what their guidelines are. He will have to be a descendant of King David in Isaiah 11:1. But how would he do this when this paper is a lie? By his blood. They have a sample of the blood of Jesus Christ that Ron Wyatt took into the lab in January, the same year that Prince William was born. It's a sample that Ron Wyatt took off the mercy seat, and they know it. This will prove he is the lineage of King David, and the Jews know it's real. They also have been told that as soon as this man of sin has been revealed, they will know on that at that time were to find the Ark of the Covenant. This completes everything they need to put inside the new temple. But yet still, there is more proof I have that he is the Antichrist, and I will show you this in part 3.